There's a couple of decisions to make here in order to establish your brand identity. Before we get to the fun stuff, who's your target audience? What type of work, information, or community members are you trying to attract? I'll include some more resources on how to identify your target audience in the description below. To provide some context to this walkthrough, I'll talk about my experience as a freelance editor. As a freelancer, I didn't want to shoot any video. I only wanted to edit it. So the target audience, the kind of work I was trying to attract, was going to come from freelance cinematographers who didn't want to edit. What do you need to tell your audience, and how can you tell them visually? What images can you use to represent your work? Whatever your craft is, what's special about the way that you do it? As an editor, I'm personable and communicative, and this is what I came up with. Now let's talk about the aesthetic of your brand identity. You'll need to identify a small color palette to store for reference. I would recommend choosing two complementary colors, one as a base and one as an accent. We offer a tool to help you do this, called Adobe Color. Use the harmony rules on the left-hand side of the screen to narrow your palette down and drag the circles around the color wheel to be automatically provided with the colors that match best with whatever color you choose. It's quite the algorithm. To add more variation while staying within my color scheme, I like to choose a lighter version of my base color as well as a darker version. The accent color never changes. On top of those brand choices, you can always use neutral colors like black, white, and gray. Once you've chosen your color palette, store the color codes somewhere you can easily access them, like in your color library or even as a note in your phone. And then think about how you can incorporate these colors into your imagery, logos, and assets. At minimum, I'd recommend creating an icon. It can be as simple as your initials, or you can get creative and make an original piece that's representative of your work, like my green headphone girl. I'd also recommend keeping some assets on hand, like icons for Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and any contact information you'd like to share. There's a link to some free social media icons in the description below. Finally, we can choose your fonts. I use Adobe fonts because it's simple to activate them into Premiere, and you can do it in real time, meaning I can activate it from Adobe fonts, give it a second to sync, and then the font's available within Premiere without even needing to restart the app. I also like the filters available on the left-hand side because it makes it easier to find the vibe I'm looking for. When choosing a font, contrast is key. Serif fonts go well with sans serifs, lighter fonts go well with bold lettering, italics go well with straight lettering, etc., etc. If you'd like a more in-depth study of font pairing, there's a link below. Once you've made these choices, we can build the design in the graphics panel to create a branded template that you can use again and again. Watch our walkthrough of the essential graphics panel in Premiere Pro to learn how to build the assets of your brand identity. If you have any questions about this concept, feel free to reach out to us on Twitter @AdobeCare. We'll be happy to help.